بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم، الحمد للہ وکفا وسلام علی عباده الذین اصطفى، اما بعد، قال اللہ تبارک و تعالی فی الکلام المجید والفرقان الحمید، بعد اعوذ باللہ من الشیطان الرجیم، بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم، ظہر الفساد فی البر والبحر بما قصبت ایلی الناس، قال رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم، الطائب حبیب اللہ، صدق اللہ مولانا العظیم و صدق رسول النبی الکریم، و نحن ولا ذالک من الشاہدین و الشاکرین، والحمد للہ رب العالمین، اللہم صلی علی سیدنا محمد و علی آل سیدنا محمد و بارک وسلم وصلی علیہ، اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم وصل عليه، اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم وصل عليه، ربي اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي، ربي زدني علما، سبحانك لا علم لنا الا ما علمتنا انك انت العلیم الحکیم، ربی یسر ولا تعسر وتنبه بالخیر. مائی موسٹ ریسپیکٹ برادرز اینڈ سسٹر ان اسلام و ناظرین، السلام علیکم رحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ. لیٹس برنگ اور ہارٹس اینڈ اور مائنڈز ان دا اسٹیٹ آف الشکر. یا اللہ، million trillion time uncountable, we thank you. You blessed us with Islam, Iman. At this moment, we are Muslim, Mu'min. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with the last breath with Iman and Islam. Ameen. I quoted before you a part of Ayat Mubarak of Surah Ar-Rum, Ayat number 41. The simple meaning of this ayat mubaraka is this: zahra al-fasad fil barri wal bahr. All corruption which is happening and happened or will happen is because of the sins committed by the human being, by the hand of human being, what kind of bad act they did. It's a chaos. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warning us, if you are peace and tranquility in the dunya, you have to stop committing the sins. What is the sin? Disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, disobeying Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, not to paying the haqooq of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and not to paying the haqooq of al-ibad, makhluq of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the sign of the sin is this: after any action, if your inner self feel exhilaration, happiness, that's a good deed. But if you feel uncomfortable, then and it prick your heart, your mufti sitting in your heart, you say it's not good, that is a sin. Now, this ayat of barakah continue that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may give them some kind of persecution, some kind of hardships, so they realize that it happened because of sins and they may return back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and start doing virtuous deed. I quoted before you Hadith Pak, At-Tayyib Habibullah, one of the best medicine of committing the sin is At-Tawbah. The people who do Tawbah, their Habibullah, Allah loves them. They mehboob of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah loves those people who do tawbah. Why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves us, He wants to take us to Jannah. And our sins committed may stop us for a while. Even if we die as a mu'min, but some sins are such, they will stop us going to Jannah right away. Therefore, the purpose should be, we should lead sin-free life. So that with the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we enter Jannah worry free. Now, what are the side effects? Bad thing what happened? What are the nuksanat? What will bad happen? What punishment can happen if we commit the sin? Number one, now the person who commits sin, he will devoid of the ilm. He cannot get good knowledge, even dunya knowledge. The children, students who have bad company, a bad friend, or they use social media, what do you think? They will get A grade? No. It will not, they cannot get good knowledge of dunya or deen or any alim, any student of ilm. Is also social, is involved in the bad social media, other kind of sin he committing. So he will not get the real knowledge of the deen. Why? The knowledge is a noor. Imam Shafi Rahimullah says, knowledge is a noor. It does not enter in the heart which is full of sins. We have to keep our mind and heart clean. They are a part of the ilm. Then, we lose the risk. Person who people who commit the sin, the risk go down. The risk go down, they cannot get good job. Or they have job, they are committing some sin in the job, they are not paying the haq of the employer, of the master. So what will happen? He will fire him. When a person gets fired, fired means dismissed. So, of course, he will lose the risk. By sins, iman go down. Any bad deed we do, iman go down. Every bad deed, any good deed we do, iman go up. Plus, what happened to Azazel? Azazel was a good worshipper. He had a lot of knowledge, but he disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He didn't do only one sajda. Then he was cursed. He was defaced. Then come on. Nuh alayhi salam, his qawm, they disobey Nuh alayhi salatu wa salam. He did dawah 950 years. Only 80 or 90 people obeyed him, became Muslim. In the long run, a big flood came, all gone. Even his own son was drowned also, because he did not obey his father. Then what happened to Qaum-e Aad? Qaum-e Aad, they are very strong, very, very tall, 90 feet high people, very strong. And they were destroyed by the wind. Qaum-e Samud, they used to make the houses in the mountains. The azab came on them, they disobey. Azab came on them. As a result of that, one strong cry teeth bust their heart. Then come on, Pharaoh. What are wrong with Pharaoh? Biggest sin he committed, not shirk even. The highest than shirk, he claimed himself, I am Allah, I am Rabb, I am your Rabb. So he is still in Egypt. He still, his body still in Egypt as a sign for us, a lesson for us, who are claiming his Lord himself. Haman, what happened to him? Namrud, Shaddad, Abu Jahl, all this history of Islam is full of that. We should actually read the Islamic history. To pass any BS exam, we read British history, American history. Of course, we should read American history, but what about history of Islam? We should spend some time to learn about the biography of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Sahaba Karam and history of Islam. Then we know what happened in the past. The people did bad thing, what happened to them? The people who did good thing, what nice, fine results they got. So on. Now question arises. The punishment, sometimes punishment come after the sin right away. Sometimes we commit any sin, punishment come right away. And we blame somebody else. Sometimes punishment come after a while, because he's Hakim. We commit sin today, we did zulm on today somebody, we murder somebody, and after 5-10 years, he was murdered. By his loved one was murdered. The things come like that. Sometime in the old age, the sin was committed in the youth, but result come in the old age. Why is so? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want to give us relief. May my banda remember his sin. May my banda seek forgiveness. May my banda do tawbah. Because tawbah wash away sins. We do true tawbah. It's why we wash away sins. Sometime punishment is not shown in the dunya. It comes all the way life hereafter. That is very dangerous. If we commit any sin, the punishment is pending for life hereafter. That is very dangerous. We cannot afford that, the punishment of the akhirat. May Allah save all of us. There are more problems come because of when we commit sin. Remember that if we commit one sin, after one sin, this sin attract other sin. Example, I look in the video, I look a drama, nice woman there. Then I want to look another drama. Go to YouTube, look bad picture. Then Shaitan say, okay, look more. Another example, we look with the eyes, ghair mehram, then we want to talk to her. Then we want to shake hand with her. We want to have relation. Every sin attract another sin. Small sin, the bigger, bigger and bigger. Therefore, we should stop sin right away. Don't consider this minor or major. Sin is a sin. disobedience is a disobedience, no matter what it is, according to Imam Qayyum Rahmatullah Alayh. Let me tell you, some women are very pretty, but because committing the sin, because committing the sin, their face become ugly, unattractive. Some men even, because of sin, look at their face. Look at Hindus. They are mushrik, right? They know noor on their face. Do you notice it? A mu'min has noor on the face. A kafir has not noor on the face. So, we have to decorate our heart with good deeds, because sin bring black spot in the heart. Black spot, black spot, black spot. As a result of that, that is mirrorized by the face. The person who commits sin, he cannot sleep well. He lose peace of mind. After committing sin, you cannot get peace. Temporarily, you'll be very happy. Temporarily, you'll be happy. But after a while, forget about that. You will repent yourself. You will lower your own self. What I did, what I did, what I did, I should have done it. Cannot sleep. Need a peace of mind. The people who commit sin, their mind does not work properly. Their thinking is a side effect of the sins committed. Sometimes it happens, the people lose iman also. For a moment, because excessive of the sins, such sins they commit, they may lose iman. Example, if somebody disrespect any alim, alim haq, disrespect any alim, abuse any alim, there's every danger he may lose iman. But looking at the face of an alim is an ibadat. And there are warasatul anbiya. We should be very watchful. Sometimes we start commenting about the ulama for nothing. We should be very watchful. They are warasatul anbiya. We should have great honor and respect. They are taking care of the job of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Let me tell you, the person whose life is not pure, he commits a sin, he will have lot of problem. What do you think? The person stealing is a sin. He caught up. Where he will go? He will go to jail. People murder. Temporarily they are happy. Where they go then? Jail for whole life. Sometimes they are hanged. These are the result of committing the sin. So, let me tell you frankly, the people who commit the sin, their life is become short. They shorten their life because they don't have peace of mind. When you don't have peace of mind, you have a lot of problems. You get anxiety, you get depression, and you get heart attacks. You understand, brother? We should keep our life sin-free. What is Islam? Islam is, when we say we are Muslim, it means we are submitted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What He commands, even I don't understand, I have to obey it. My life is zahiran and batinan. External and internal should be according to சுன்னா முஹம்மது ஸல்லல்லாஹு அலைஹி வஸல்லம். நவ் சம் பனிஷ்மெண்ட் ஐ ஜஸ்ட் டாக் டு யூ அபவுட் த துனியா. வாட் இஸ் த பனிஷ்மெண்ட்? சம் பனிஷ்மெண்ட் இன் தி ஆக்ரத், வெரி டேஞ்சரஸ். த பர்சன் ஹூ டஸ் லாய் ஹீ வில் பி கவுண்டட் இன் த முனாஃபிகீன். தேர்ஸ் த்ரீ சைன் ஆஃப் முனாஃபிக். எ முனாஃபிக் பனிஷ்மெண்ட் இஸ் மோர் தேன் த காஃபிர். த்ரீ சைன் இஃப் வி ஹேவ் வி ஆர் முனாஃபிக். வென் யூ மேக் ப்ராமிஸ் வி டோன்ட் ஒபே ப்ராமிஸ், வி பேக் அவுட். வி யூஸ் பாலிட்டிக்ஸ், வி பேக் அவுட் த ப்ராமிஸ். நம்பர் டூ, சம்படி கிவ் அஸ் சம் அமானா ட்ரஸ்ட், வி ஈட் அப், வி டோன்ட் கிவ். நம்பர் த்ரீ, பர்சன் ஹூ லைஸ் இஸ் ஆல்சோ சைன் ஆஃப் முனாஃபிக். The may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from the nifaq, because nifaq, hypocrisy, is the biggest sin which may take to jahannam. So we cannot afford jahannam, brother. Even in the dunya, the sinful person is not respected. Nobody respects him. In one family member, we are a noble family, one of us, he start drinking or drink sometime, will we respect him? Even my relative, close relative, if I see, I know he drinking, he drink alcohol or he does gambling, I will not let him come in my house. Why? My children, my family member may have the same habit, and the gambler always steal. They're thief. When gambler lose the money, they go and steal the money. So he may come to my house, steal some my ornament of my wife even. Am I right? Even my close relative, maybe brother-in-law, I don't care, my real brother, I will not encourage him come in my house. So the person who commits sins, he lose the social respect also. Do we know the people who commit zina in the day of, in the akhirat, they will be thrown in the big oven, the noor, big oven of fire. So big oven of fire, people who commit adultery, they will be moving up and down in their fire. Iyaz billah, may Allah save every woman from such kind of crime and sin. The people who don't pay zakat, this is a very serious matter about zakat. We should fix that date and ask any mufti, tell your all possessions, what we have, money, plots, stocks, and ask how I pay zakat. But most of us don't want to disclose. If I have $100,000, I don't want to tell any alim, any mufti, right? So but I'll be smart, I will tell him, oh, I have example, farz kiya, I have $10,000. I have 8 tola jewelry. You understand my point? Tell less. So he will calculate for you that this is zakat. Then I calculate in my home also, multiply and pay right zakat. The person does not pay zakat, his wealth will become like a serpent snake. This is wealth in the neck, in the day of Qiyamah. Can we afford it? We are scared of snake. If a snake come over here, we run away. And this, who told this? This is not Maulana told. No, 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 no. Sadiqul Masduq, the most truthful personality, whose status is Baad Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Sadiq Amin, he gave us the news in Sahih Ahadith. Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We cannot deny it. We should be careful, watchful. The person who does not make salat, only Jummah not enough. Even do we know that in the safar, musafir, the Jummah is not farz even. Do you know that? But salat is farz even on musafir. He have to make half. Regular salat is more important than Jummah salat. It does not mean we should not make Jummah salat. A person does not come to Jummah salat. Something will be written on his forehead. Bad word. I don't say that. On the forehead, who doesn't make Jummah salat. So we should not become Muslim only Jummah Muslim or Eidi Muslim. We should be 5 times salah make. Otherwise, there is a big punishment. The person does not make 5 times salat, that will be day of Qiyamah. Lie down. It was shown to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the dream. The person throw stone on him, bust his head, and then the stone roll away. By that time, head is good again, and again is thrown on the head. Iyaz billah, may Allah forgive us. We should be punctual 5 times salat. The people don't make salat. Let me tell you, their rizq go down. One of my friend told me, he drive taxi. He said, Shaykh, when salat time come, I try to make close to the masjid, make my salat in time. He said, believe me, after I finish salat, Allah gave me such nice passenger. Go to JFK, LaGuardia, good sawari, good money. So please, because it is rizq. From salat, it comes rizq. Some people have internal sin, like a bugs, grudge against the relative, grudge against somebody else, grudge against husband or wife. Kina bugs, do we know that? In the night of Laylat al-Qadr, no dua will be accepted of this person who has bugs against somebody. Some nation have books against other nation. Some men have books against other languages even. Please, we should keep our heart clean from every kind of kina and bugs and enmity. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, love will not enter in the heart. Rasul Akram sallallahu alaihi wasallam, love will not enter in the heart, which is full of bugs. Please, we have to keep our, forgive the people. You know why we get bugs? Why? Because somebody did wrong to me. Somebody bothered me. Somebody did loss to me. Somebody did not give rishta of a daughter to my son. Because my son is not good. They don't want, but we keep bugs, right? Why he did not give rishta, his daughter, to my son? Because people do something bad. Please, solution, forgive the people. Clean, keep your heart clean. Make heart clean from books. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cannot enter, will not enter in the heart, will not enter in the heart who has books a dirty heart. In dirty plate, we don't even eat food. Please. And some are such jealousy, backbiting. If you do that, the amal, good deeds are transferred to other person. We got nothing. I did a lot of hajj, zakat, tabligh, bayan, waaz, a day of Qiyamah, But I was doing backbiting. Other people will take away my reward. What I got? Zero. We should be careful. It is very good to do good deed. But it is more important to save good deed. You understand? बहुत अच्छा है नेक काम करना, पर नेकियों को बचाना भी ज़रूरी है, उससे ज़्यादा अच्छा है. यू गॉट डॉलर इन द पॉकेट, सैलरी कैश सैलरी, एंड द पॉकेट हैज होल्स. व्हाट हैपन? व्हाई गॉन होम, मनी फॉल डाउन. दैट्स इट. इन दिस एरिया द किबर, किबर इज अ वेरी वेरी बिग गुना after shirk. Of course we don't commit shirk, we don't bow down on the kabur, this and that, but riya is a shirk-e khafi. To do any job, any dog deed to show the people, get appreciation of the people. The same way the kibar, arrogance, the person who has iota of arrogance, he says, Jisa Pak in Fazale Amal, any person, woman, has iota, little bit arrogance in the heart, cannot smell the fragrance of the paradise. What is arrogance? I am better than other. I am better than other. That's looking for. I am better than other. So we should think every other person better than me. Especially I always tell 99.9% where husband, we men, think we are better than the wife. Dalil. How many are sitting over here? Ask our wife, honey, make dua for me. No, very rare. Is that true? Men normally think we are better than the wife. Even she, Rabia Basriya, she makes the hajjat. Mujaddid Millat, Hazrat Maulana Ashraf Thanvi Rahmatullah Alayh used to say, ihtisaban, sawab ke lihaz se, I think, consider every Muslim is better than me. And ihtimalan, perhaps, maybe, and I also, every disbeliever, I think every disbeliever is better than me. Maybe tomorrow he become Muslim, get shahada, and I have no guarantee of my iman. Yes or no? We have to make dua for all our American brothers and sisters, they are Christian or Jew, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them with iman, and they should also enjoy Jannat al-Firdaus. Why we commit sin? Why we commit sin? Number one, we have weak iman. We don't think Allah is watching me. We don't have real practical belief. We commit sin, nobody watching me. Nobody watching me. Allah is watching us, wherever we are. Sometimes people say, who care? Who care? Shaitan put in the mind arrogance. Allah from the care. We are his abd and banda. So I think nobody watching me, and I cannot hide myself. There is a very short story. Umar bin Abdullah bin Umar radiallahu ta'ala anho, Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anho, he was going, he saw a shepherd, he asked him, please give me goat. I give you money. He said, no. Abdullah ibn Umar told him, look, why not? Take money, man. He said, no, because my master, I didn't get permission of my master to give you. So Abdullah ibn Umar told him, he's not here. He's not here. Your master, tell him, wolf came and took away one sheep. What he said? Gadariya. What he Gadariya said? Listen. And Allah, where is Allah? Abdullah ibn Umar, Allah is watching us. If we have this belief, Allah is watching us. Hova ma'akum amakuntum. Allah is with me. He is watching everybody now. Who is listening carefully, not listening carefully. What I am talking is listening. If we have this belief, we cannot commit any sin. Yes or no? We are bringing sifat up. So therefore, the person be haya hai, woh ghairat hai, shameless person who disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, how much he suffered for us, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We should love them, respect them. The person who loves Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, respect Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he cannot commit any sin. What ilaj? What should we do now? Quran tells it very clearly. Wazaru zahir al isma wa batina. It's a command. Like salat. Wazaru zahir al isma wa batina. Leave, abandon, stop committing external sins and internal sins. External sin like theft, telling lie. Internal sin like arrogance, jealousy. Stop it. And second, we should do tawbah. Best medicine Allah gave us. He wanted to give us Jannah. Command came. Ya ayyuhal amanu tubu ilallah tawbah tundasu. O believer, do true, sincere tawbah. That's it. Allah so Rahim and Kareem. If we do sincere tawbah, sometime, according to sincerity, he changes. Allah sometimes changes the bad deed into good deed. Ajib. Our bad deed, sins can be changed into good deed if we do sincere tawbah. Give the haqq of the person. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wake up the salat. I am now closing now. So let's do tawbah now. We are in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala today. We feel ashamed. Come, bring your heart, your face, your heart in the condition of shame. I will request everybody lower your head and feel ashamed. We did not commit, we commit some sins. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, forgive us. We promise we will not do again. Inshallah, say with me, Astaghfirullah, Rabbi, min kulli zambin wa atubu ilay. Astaghfirullah, Rabbi, min kulli zambin wa atubu ilay. Astaghfirullah, Rabbi, min kulli zambin wa atubu ilay. Ya Allah, forgive our sins, what we committed, daylight, night light, night time, ya samal our sin, we promise in your house, inshallah, we will not commit any sin. With your mercy, with your help, we will not commit any sin no more. Wa akhir da'wana and alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. We should have full yakin our all sins have been forgiven. Amen. Jazakallah khair, shukran kaseera.